round of applause to both teams that have made it thus far. Firstly, I would like to introduce our honourable judges that we have today. We have a very big panel. On my far left, we have Mr. Tomoya Yonaga. He is working for a consulting company and is the chief adjudicator of the upcoming Northeast Asian Open. To his right, we have Mr. Heishiro Kanagawa. He is a student with a major in computer science. Next, we have Mr. Matthew Nock. He is a student of biomedical science. We now have Ms. Sofia Rodriguez. She is studying mathematics and economics at the London School of Economics. Beside her is Ms. Daisy Ohan. She is in her final year studying English at University of Exeter, and she has been captain of debating for 2 years. In the row behind, we have Ms. Aoba Niki. She is a country officer at Japan International Corporation Agency. We also have Mr. Naoki Enomoto. He is a student in the Graduate School of Tokyo Institute of Technology. We next have Mr. Katie Routledge. He is an English Literature graduate from the University of Birmingham. Next in line is Ms. Darla Cornett. She is an English teacher and also an editor. Next, we have Mr. Kozo Ota. He says, proud hail from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, go Habs. Next, we have Mr. Kohei Arakawa. He is a graduate of ICU and he's currently in Hitotsubashi University. We also have Mr. Akinao Kosaki. He graduated from Seikei University and he was a quarter finalist of ESUJ in 2010. We have Ms. Masako Suzuki. She is a lecturer at Kanagawa University and Keio University. We have Isao Ayabe. Mr. Isao Ayabe. He is an associate professor at Tokai University. And concluding our 15-man panel, we have Mr. Takuya Kitaoka. He graduated from Nagoya University and he is now working for a consulting firm. Now, the motion for the grand finals is that we would abolish the retirement age in Japan. Without any further ado, I'd like to call upon the Prime Minister, Mr. Shingo Fujita, to open their case within 7 minutes. Yes, sir.
Government believes in three key premises in advancing their case. Firstly, individual who wants to work should continue on work by individual will. Secondly, elderly population should receive and benefit from financial and cultural prestige. Three, young population's burden, i.e. social welfare, childcare, labor standard problem, should be lessened and rectified for intergenerational justice. Followed by premises, three arguments. Firstly, how abolishing the retirement allows an individual who wants to continue to work benefit from the eye or preserving his or her identity. Secondly, how abolishment of retirement age benefits elderly in material and cultural respects. Three, how young generation's burden will be lessened on our side. Model, corporation will no longer be required to make individual retire when they reach a certain age, i.e. 65 years old in many occasions, but it may be diverse in job opportunity. For example, if for a university professor, it is 75 years. For example, we abolish in those kind of like age being a criteria for corporation as well as the institution requiring the individual to retire. Pension would be given to those individuals who retire from the work. For example, if you choose to work, there's no pension. But there is no, if you choose not to work, there would be offered a pension in decent amount. Or also, we would have a gradual disappearance of cultural norm associated with the retirement age of Japan, for example, on our side of the house. So, given this, first argument, individual right to continue working. Work is a source of individual identity and constitute who you are. Let's talk about personal, but my grandfather's story, who had passed away 4 years ago. He had engaged in elementary school teachers for 40 years. And what he loved were teach and interact with children. For example, when he had to retire from the age at the age of 60, and after that he had a syndrome of depression. Why? Because the most important source of individual identity for him was to engage in work for him. In comparison to that, we on our side of the house, my grandpa was able to choose not to continue on work, and therefore he would have a constant choice not to have to preserve that identity, so that we would have less any individual lost their and suffer from identity crisis on our side of the house. The identity crisis, depression, those sort of things should be considered as something absurd and disgusting, because the arbitrary time frame in which individuals do not necessarily choose to opt into that system have suffered from individual identity crisis is something unacceptable from Waseda University teammate. We think particularly in Japan, what you were intertwined with here after this point in the status, and oftentimes people necessarily have to think and aspire a future dream from their his or her childhood, for example. The strong consciousness as well as attachment to the particular work that he or she engaged is kind of strong emotional attachment to that individual, and when suddenly individuals of the government system deprived from that kind of strong attachment, is that something absurd? And we can rectify exclusive frame from Waseda. Yes.
Why are you okay with the depression of the younger generation currently unemployed?
Then you have to be comparative with my third argument, because we would collectively serve the interest of the young generation on our side. Second, elderly population's benefit. The first material benefit neurologically proposed on our side is a status quo. Pension is paid so less to individual, so to some occasion, which causes the problem of elderly being under poverty. It allows individual to gain more material need by their own, for example. Especially, this is especially important because less in poverty faced by elderly is something positive from government perspective. But furthermore, the cultural norm as well as corporations norm associated with the culture intertwined with the retirement age is that corporation disincentivized to hire elderly because it seems to be incapable, it seems to be unproductive in comparison to other people. Ladies and gentlemen, it deprives individual to live up from poverty. We think age is not an exception for an individual to live under poverty, and that's absurd, and the Waseda Association is going to solve on our side. But also culture, right? Elderly can live with self-pride comparatively on our side of the house, because they can think, I'm still valuable, I can be still comparatively contributing to my corporation as well as my dream to as well as the job opportunity that I'm going to engage to that. But and also this is critically important, because the growing narrative which exists in internet right wing, which is called Neto Uyo in Japan, for example, is that to say elderly is one of the skewing and parasite of our society, that the social budget is still exclusively parasitically deprived by those individuals, and our social budget is more likely to be lessened, less deprived the right of the soul like elderly. I don't care about how people is going to be under poverty situation for those elderly individuals. For example, we will lessen the kind of cultural norm as well as the social norm associated but with the status quo, because elderly can show by his or herself, for example, they actively engage to cooperate cooperation and work and show their potentiality as well as the contribution which can be shown as something positive to younger generation or people who wants to criticize those elderly individuals. On that basis, we would like to, or we will solve that kind of problem on our side of the house, and that's beneficial. Three, future generation and young generation. This is a direct clash against the question from Deputy Opposition Leader. First benefit we will suggest is that pensions burden would be comparatively lessened for young generation, because we believe young generations is have a huge problem with regard to the burden on pension being, you know, so hugely burdened to those individuals. We will lessen that kind of huge burden towards young generation. We are not having a magical policy that both future generation burden will be zero on our side, but we would like to have a lesson of general people who are having a burden, because we allow individuals to continue on working. We will allow individuals to gain more money so that market will be circulated and economic vitalization will be more likely to be occur, which necessarily also increase in job opportunity for young generations as well. For example, when elderly buy things, for example, it increased the employee opportunity for like Muji, Uniqlo, etc. for individual young generation to engage in work. But furthermore, expenditure towards the family increases. It is particularly important for financial assistance to the daughter, for example, especially in Japan, many females have a difficulty in finding job and continue work on job opportunity, for example. And the reason why we have less children being born on the basis of financial difficulty will be likely to solve on our side of the house. But furthermore, critically, we will share a labor standard problem. For example, when elderly is more likely to engage in job opportunity, for example, it shares the problem of black企業, black corporation, for example, with the abusive corporation syndrome which have to engage on our side, which will be critically important, because once elderly, which is a vast majority of population, constitute and are moving forward to combat that kind of black企業 problem, we will solve a positive benefit for young generations as well. For a collective benefit for future generations of the current generation in Japan, Waseda is supremely proud to propose this policy.
I thank the Prime Minister for his speech. Next, let's call upon the Leader of Opposition, Takuma Yamanishi, to open their case within 7 minutes. Hear her.
We believe that the retirement of older generation is the basis to deal with the problems that are raised by the government side. We believe the decision-making power should rather be provided to the younger generation rather than being kept forever in the hands of older generation who tend to stick on older conventions that are toxic in the Japanese context. That's why we think this motion should fall. So the model we support is quite simple, right? We oppose older generations to govern the corporations in the context in which older people are the ones who take power within the Japanese context. It's called seniority system, in which we think is toxic. We have to oppose this kind of system. We oppose nominal like presidents or like, you know, honorable presidents who exist in Japan. We think all of those individuals should not be exist in the very first place. But still, we think like the new leaders like that are being like, you know, chosen after those people retire can also seek advice from those older generation. We think in terms of like running the government itself, we don't think there's any problem in that. We think the decision-making power is what is at stake in this debate. We think that should be rather in the hands of the younger generation. Based on this, I'm going to talk about two things. Firstly, how in their paradigm, a lot of problems that are pervasive within Japan are unlikely to be fixed because of the power of changing the corporate structure is in the hands of the older individuals. And second, how in our paradigm, younger generations having power can better tackle those issues. But before that,
rebuttals to the previous speaker. So he basically said three things. First, he said, you know, work is very important for individuals, and we agree, right? But still, corporations are allowed to lay off individuals within their corporation. Why? Because we believe that corporations also have a right to secure their own corporate function when those individuals are actually causing burdens to the company in the very first place. And we think corporations have a very good reason as to think of set retirement age in terms of for the older generation, because what I'm gonna explain in my substantives. So second, he said, you know, elderly people will be alleviated from poverty when we still keep on hiring them. Like, we support a model still like the current paradigm in which corporations are, a lot of corporations are hiring individuals who have already retired, right? But they might not be in the position of making crucial decisions in the corporation, but still they can function as important individuals within the corporation. We think that's still okay, right? They say, you know, people think that older people are incapable, or so on and so forth. The Abe government currently is strongly pushing for the employment of elderly individuals. Like, we already have legislations in which we demand corporations to hire certain number of elderly people. We don't think this motion is particularly necessary in order to achieve their goal in the first place. Thirdly, they said, you know, pension will be there will be less paying of pension, which means it's good for young people. This still doesn't quite engage with what my partner said, right? Under Waseda's goal, when a lot of older individuals still remain in the corporations, they are taking away the rooms for younger generations to come in because of the limited capacity of the corporations. We think those older generations are kicking them out. We think, comparatively speaking, younger people should at least have a place inside. And that's that are the rebuttals, and moving on to my first issue, right? So what happens when the older generations keep on having the authority or the decision-making power in their paradigm? Necessary adjustments or reforms that are to adjust to the reality in the society is extremely difficult in their paradigm. What do I mean? Before moving on, yes.
Do you think young people are intrinsically better decision makers than old people?
Okay, so that's not what I'm saying, right? Because, okay, I'll say this later, but I'll say it now anyway. Younger people are the ones who will be remaining in that corporation for 40 or 30 years on, right? Those older individuals, like over 65 or 70, only have 10 years or so on, right? We think this fact itself makes the decision-making different, and we think that's detrimental. I'm gonna come back to this later. So when those individuals have the power, those older individuals, tend to stick on the conventional ideas that are toxic in Japan, for example, like the preferring men over women within corporations, like supporting a seniority system, or supporting a long working hours that were quite prevalent in the 1970s, 70s, or 80s. Those individuals already have this perception that this is what I myself have endured, and therefore, young people should have the guts in order still keep on working in the same paradigm. Right? People who have this kind of confidence in what they did in the very first place, they think that, for example, female CEOs, which are few in Japan but still exist in Japan, they think that they have achieved that position through battling against the sexist structure within that. So they think that younger female generation should also fight back, and they try not to change the system in the very first place. They think that's hugely detrimental. And especially in terms of toxic seniority system, what happens is that it directly attacks their self-interest when they're actually in power, right? Because when older people are actually taking power within the corporation, crack down on seniority system, it's directly gonna damage themselves, right? Because they are the ones who are having power within the corporation. We think, comparatively speaking, even younger people are in power, younger people can make better decisions in terms of tackling the seniority system. What is so problematic about these toxic cultures? For example, the seniority system is making the situation in which length of how much you work in that corporation actually matters in terms of how much income you get. What does this mean? This blocks the fluidity of labor market within Japan. So people, for example, are difficult to opt out from certain particular harsh labor environment, because if they opt out, their money, their salary is gonna decrease, right? And in terms of maximizing their own utility, when they think their ability cannot be maximized in that corporation, it's still very difficult for them to opt out, which leads to misallocation of individuals within Japan. We think Japan, which is facing the decreasing of the population, is very important to maximize its productivity. We think all of these fixed structures
structures should be changed. So second, how does this change this? When authority is, or the decision-making power is in the young, hands of younger generations, it's much easier to adjust to the reality because they don't have this like experience in the very first place to have gone through this harsh, like toxic Japanese culture, right? They think that we should engage and change these kind of systems. And therefore, it's when they actually have the power with them, it's much more likely that they're gonna tackle those like long working environments because they themselves suffer from that, and because they are young, they don't have this dream that people should tackle this within the current context. They can be inclusive to LGBTs because they're comparatively speaking more like having modern education. In terms of all of these, we think the power of decision making within corporations should be in the hands of younger generations, and therefore we think this motion should fall. Thank you.
I thank the Leader of Opposition, and to continue the case for side government, I'd like to call upon the Member of Government, Alex Taylor. Taylor.
Retirement age in countries like Japan has not been responsive to changes in life expectancy which affect the way that welfare payments have to be distributed in the economy, and it's not been responsive to changes in individual preferences where more and more people want to stay in corporate environments that they derive their identities from. This kind of system should by definition be abolished because it's inconsistent with these two fundamental ideas. And those are the two main ideas I'm going to bring you. How forced retirement harmed many individuals in society, those who would choose to stay in companies and have to pursue individual autonomy is how you want to protect, not to protect their autonomy to stay in those roles. And then second, how does forced retirement harm the Japanese economy in a context where the Japanese economy doesn't have much breathing space to accept random harms? First off, we have a few points of rebuttal to their case. They tell us, first of all, that what they really want to do is radically change the corporate structure and indeed the entire culture of Japan so that young people have all the power. So three reasons why this doesn't actually make sense. First, because like within a company, older people still tend to advance more quickly than younger people because companies value things like experience and training, because that means you're better able to contextualize your decisions, you're likely to be more respected as a leader because like just as human beings, we tend to respect older figures who have experience, who've proven themselves to survive a corporate culture that often gets rid of people more strongly. So we think that's why younger people aren't gonna have like automatic power to change the system anyway. Second, my POI is relevant, right? Younger people do not necessarily make better decisions than older people. These guys say that older people are more conventional, they hold to a certain set of values that young people don't. We say that like, younger people in Japan are still actually quite conventional. I've seen surveys that suggest this is the most conservative generation in 50 years, and they still overwhelmingly vote for the LDP, return the same governments as their parents and their grandparents. Third idea, like we don't have to defend the seniority system, guys. You don't need to give us 4 minutes of analysis on how that's bad. But we don't think the seniority system's record is that bad anyway, right? Look at the way in which Japan developed as the world's second largest economy. It's still the world's third largest economy, despite being by population, like I think the 12th largest country. It's clearly a system that doesn't do too bad of a job in orienting companies towards better development. Next, they tell us that we already hire retired people in some roles, so it's kind of okay, right? We tell you that that's largely an unpaid or ceremonial role, which strengthens the narrative around old people as kind of window dressing for companies. Like, they're just kind of someone who we allow to show that we're responsive to concerns of age and these sorts of things. So then they go on to sort of expand this and tell us that legislation already like forces companies to hire older people. We think this is problematic because maybe it does, maybe that exists, but they're all going to be funneled into lower paid jobs. I'm pretty sure that's the case, right? Those are the kinds of jobs that are targeted. If you've been a middle manager all your life, you've enjoyed the status of a permanent stable job, the wage, the status, all these sorts of things, your identity as an individual is compromised when you're suddenly consigned to working in a convenience store. That means you perceive your value to society to have been lowered through factors that are beyond your control because no one can stop themselves from aging, right? That is a problem. We don't want to harm these individuals in this way. Finally, they tell us that under status quo, young people are losing out in a way that's unfair. We tell you that it's the status quo that is unfair to the young of Japan. We think that this idea that like they have to work and work and pay for what is an increasing welfare burden of the older generation as the population ages, right? The more old people you have, the more pensions you have to pay, and pensions are expensive. If you abolish mandatory retirement, the share of the total national revenue that comes in through taxation is less distributed in pensions, less money has to be spent on that, right? Which means the state can invest more in things like education, things like training, training for the young people. We were quite happy to support that. We think that's a very valid aim. It's very important. We have more money to do it with, to better serve those people's interests, even if total jobs decrease. We don't necessarily think that total jobs in the economy will decrease, because we think that older people tend to spend more than younger people, ceteris paribus, right? Because we think they have a shorter horizon, shorter time span, they're more likely to want to enjoy more of their wealth and spend more of it on consumer goods and things like that. So we think the demand will rise, which creates more jobs for younger people too. Now, forced retirement harms many individuals in society. We think individual autonomy is important, and a key function of that is your choice to work, right? Your ability to choose to work. Many people don't want to retire from their jobs under status quo, and they are forced out by this mandatory age. Why is this bad? Because work is like strongly constituted of your identity, both in like general, because it's the main thing that you do, your 8 hours, like your 24-hour day, every day spent at the same office, like working your way up, contributing to the development of this corporate organism that you are a part of. And that's specifically true in Japan, where you have a very strong sense of personal identification with your corporation. So this concept of permanent employment, until very recently, was the dominant way in which things were done, where you were just a part of a larger whole, essentially, and you just assigned yourself to that and subordinated your interests to that in perpetuity. That kind of identity significance is really, really problematic, because we think that that means that those are the actions that you take that give your life meaning, is being in that environment and being that person, that side of you who works, who uses those skills, that experience to improve something you really care about, that is your company. That's what makes you you. That's what you're good at. That's what you do. And if you take that person out of that environment without their consent, you're violating their autonomy in a way that we should not allow the state to do. And we certainly should not force them to exchange that very valued expression of themselves and their role in life for like living at home and doing nothing because there's nothing really to do and they're not really used to that environment, or else maybe like meaningless travel that they don't really want to do, but they feel like everyone else who's old does that because everyone else is retired as well. So that's what the old people do. We might as well do that. That's not something that seems to be fair to those people. Consigning people to like these kinds of fates is not fair. We don't need to intervene like this. We should allow autonomy. We should, and in so doing, what do we get? We get like less stigmatization against retirees. So many people feel stigmatized as retired people in the status quo. In a society with a strong communal ethic, we are encouraged to care for your family as much as more than yourself. The sense that I'm forced to retire, I'm not pitching in, I'm unemployed, that leads to guilt, that leads to a sense of depression. That combines with the sense that many old people in Japan are socially isolated anyway, and that's very different from the social environment of work, where all your friends, your colleagues, or people you like to hang out with on a Monday morning, those people are no longer part of your life because you're stuck in your little village cabin in Nagano and you can't go back because the government says so. That is not fair. And it's even more of a problem when you have an aging population, because older people in general are more likely to be constructed as a burden on society. Or the old people are the ones who are not valuable, because we care in Japan about work. We care about our economy's productivity, and old people are not contributing to that. That further alienates those people. Next, let's move on to the idea that forced retirement harms the economy. So we accept that the Japanese economy right now is standing still, but it's not doing too badly compared to other countries. We think future trends are the real issue here. Demographics mean you have an aging population, which means, as I say, more of a proportionate share of your total budget has to go into paying for pensions. At the same time, fewer young people means there's less people to pay for that, so the burden on each individual young person is that much heavier. That's a problem, because we have more retirements, more pension payments, that's a misallocation of valuable resources. When you abolish forced retirement, you get two main consequences. First off, if you still want to retire, then you absolutely can, right? And we will pay for that, we will fund that, and that's fine. But second, so many people in this country where work is so significant as a proportion and impact on your life will keep working at 65, 70, 75. And these people are clearly a productive resource because the seniority system does seem to actually have worked quite well. Because companies staffed with older board members do seem to have succeeded in turning Japan into an economic powerhouse. Because the individuals, by virtue of their unique experience that I cannot possibly imagine, by virtue of year after year after year of making tough decisions in these corporations, they can contextualize what they think about those companies in ways that are likely to make those companies more successful than if I go in and try and like be the CEO of Hitachi, for example. That doesn't seem good. We want to lower the welfare. We want to increase demand more generally. We want to like make the old people feel more of a part of Japan and to allow them to contribute in the ways that they think best. Not intervene in the way their retirement age forces them mandatorily, problematically to do. So we're proud of those. Thank you.
Thank the member of the government. I'd like to remind the audiences to keep your mobile phones on silent, please. Now, moving on, I'd like to call upon the member of the opposition to continue their case within 7 minutes, Mr. Tomoaki Tanaka. Hear, hear.
Do you know Takuya Tanaka, who was one of the most important presidents in Japan history? He unfortunately did a very short term as a president, but after he has retired, he has been consulted by many people in the huge house across Meguro-gawa, but not having the actual substantial power, the actual authority to push forward or to override the any other wisdom proposed by the young people. Before getting to substantive, a few clarifications. We fully support the paradigm in which the retired people behind the veil, as Tanaka Kakue, as Takuma told you, the people and those people are consulted by the people who are actually working in actual places in the corporation, right? We fully support the paradigm in which the wisdom is efficiently utilized for the actual benefit of the current generation. The wisdom do not have an actual substantive, but providing wisdom to the younger generation who actually working in a working environment is better for the Japanese future. Because what we recognize here is that every single human being deserves self-determination to determine their own future and their own future by influence corporate structure. So ways in which rights are exercised on the sovereign health are too unbalanced on the sovereign health. The people who are not predilected for the current benefit of the current generation and the current this context are having the huge excessive power to influence and override any other people who are actually predicted for the current benefit of the current generation in the current context. Which is that the problem of the separate health? We haven't seen any relevant analysis from the separate health, right? So what we are opposing now? We are opposing now the older people who are not actually predilected for this kind of current generation, for this kind of current benefit of Japanese context, are they having excessive influence or actually to change the corporate nature, because they're having their own pride and they are likely to be unflexible, and they have a tendency, not incentive, but a tendency to override the people who are actually predilected for current benefit or current generation in the current Japanese context, right? No. So we say on the sovereign health are giving excessive actual power to and override the any other wisdom to people who are influenced by the current benefit by the emotion. The excessive violates the right of self-determination to determine their own future by engaging work and shape future picture of corporations in the future. What we hear from the sovereign health, right? I'd like to talk about much, but let's be clear what's irrelevant to the motion, right? They've talked about like this. So older people are likely to change the situation because they're a lot of time working in a corporation, right? To which you say that's not the point. Point here is what influences them. As they talked about, the benefit is an important source of the motivation in the first place. So those people, older people, are predicted for the benefit, not the younger generation benefit, not the current Japanese benefit. They benefit for the kind of short term, 5 years, 3 years, 2 years, which is that over influence based upon the enlightenment benefit is the kind of we are putting now. Second of all, they've talked about the older people harm. Again, we fully support the paradigm in which the people who have retired are frequently consulted by the people in the younger generation, being consulted, being respected, and can receive recognition from somebody else, not necessarily taking their particular proposal to give particular excessive power to the older generation, to give them respect or the higher identity crisis of those people. The young people can consult with those older generation he received wisdom from those people. Not necessarily those older people are fall into the identity crisis in the first place. No, this kind of giving actual power to influence actual substantial like structure of a corporation is a kind of excessive thing and kind of totally the social program mismatch in the first place, right? Tanaka does not never ever fall into the identity crisis because he has many man consulted with, even though he has had any actual power to influence. No, I'm going to you. And they've told us rational people, right? So we need to avoid rational people's rhetoric. Two responses. One, it's not exclusive, right? It's not relevant to the motion. They can never ever change by taking this proposal. The people who want to think in a particular way in a rational manner does not never change by just giving the power to other people in the first place. And second, why is it such an important in the first place? Anyway, those people sharing minority in the political manner or the political sphere, we doesn't really care about those people to take implement a particular proposal in the first place. And then what they've talked about is that is the pensions, right? We need to decrease the pensions, the expenses of the patients, and that's also the one of the primary reasons why they want to take the proposal, right? Response: why is it such an important, right? We are very happy with increasing the corporate taxation on the huge corporation in the first place. Why in order to decrease expense on the pension, we need to take the particular proposal to particularly bigger power to these older people in the first place? No, we have to have any relevant analysis. Why giving this actual substantial power in the corporate structure is such a necessary thing to fulfill and achieve their goal? All the things we've heard from some health, like identity crisis, job is the very source of their identity. Yes, we concede. That's the reason why these people consulted with many people, these people respected without this actual substantial power, is the kind of important thing we have to recognize. We don't necessarily have to give excessive power to make them respected, excessive power to decrease expense on the patient, excessive power to to save those people in the first place. So that's the point we are generating from these oppositions that totally miss. These opposition are continuously providing a material that says what excessive power is really, really, really detrimental. That increases the probability to dish a whole future generation of the Japan, because the whole future generation of Japan is currently benefited by the current current context in our current context. Right? The people who are predilected for the current benefit in the current generation should have a self-determination power, should have self-determination right. That's why it has excessive violence. We don't really think what they're talking about is not true. But what we're saying is what they're talking about today is not relevant to the motion. I'm very happy to pause.
Yeah, thank the member of the opposition, and to conclude the case for side opposition, I'd like to call upon the leader of the opposition again, Takuma Yamagishi. Hear him.
I'm going to analyze this debate from two simple questions. Firstly, which side is better from perspective of individual workers? And second, which is better from perspective of the society as a whole? So first, from the individual level, they said, you know, work is very important for people, and we generally agree, right? But they never really responded to our analysis as to how corporations already have a justification to lay off their own employees when it is necessary. And we have provided to you many reasons why it is the case in which it is necessary for you to have to regain the power to the younger generation, or people like 40 or 50 years old, right? We think this is very important. And then they said, you know, we have to provide a place to elderly people so that they can feel meaningfulness. Because in our paradigm, elderly people will only work in low-paid environment. Right, the question here is that, or the important thing here is that their benefit comes at the expense of the younger generations not being able to achieve or reach that level of meaningfulness, right? When people, leaders, older leaders keep on dominating that spot, younger people cannot access that, but that's what we have been telling you, right? You have to be comparative here. Elderly people have already experienced 40 years in that company, already went through like the ladder of like, you know, promotion. They have already experienced that leadership. We think younger people who have never had the chance should be the ones who should be comparatively favored in this particular context. They said senior people can be still productive. And that's why my partner's analysis is particularly important here, right? Yes, elderly people have a lot of expertise, a lot of experience, and that's why elderly people can still find meaningfulness in terms of actually, for example, sharing their own expertise or experience with the people who are aspiring to be CEOs, who are trying to start new businesses, right? We think that's why a lot of elderly, like, you know, Japanese, past CEOs like Konosuke Matsushita, like were the ones who are like being still having fame. We think those kind of things can not only in the very high level, but still in the local level, those things can also take place in terms of we generally respect the elderly people. We think that's still not an issue in our paradigm. Moving on to my second issue about societal level, right? So they talked about, you know, it's a problem in which elderly people are suffering in poverty, or like because like, you know, the pension, the pressure on pension system increases, so on and so forth. They have provided you with a lot of other ways in order to tackle this thing. My partner already told you how we can fix the taxation system. We can like, you know, make the pension system more efficient so that we don't have to like, you know, put so much burden on a younger generation, or like we can hire old individuals in the very first place so that they can sustain their own lives. Like their problem on a societal level was quite minute, or like not particularly compelling enough to take this motion in the very first place. And then the only response we heard from their side of the house towards our case about tackling the old system is that seniority system was good, right? Because it worked in the past. We already told you how it doesn't fit the current context of Japan, right? We are suffering a decreasing population. The Japanese companies are unable to utilize its conventional techniques or technologies and become like innovational new companies, right? This is happening because we believe that elderly people unfortunately have tendency to have pride in the conventional system, right? They are the ones who went through and achieved their own position through tackling the conventional system, which like, for example, long working hours or like seniority system, so on and so forth. Like these things are like there's a strong tendency there, but also not in terms of only those like, you know, customs. Also, for example, companies keep on, elderly people have pride in the product that the company has been producing for a very, very long time, right? So it's very difficult for them to actually change in order to adjust to the actual demands of the individuals within the society, right? In our paradigm, because younger people have much more stake in their own selves in the long term, because they're gonna stay in the corporation for like longer or so on and so forth, we think those individuals have much more flexibility in terms of changing the system and making the company itself more adjust to the society in a very long term. We think that's why this motion should fall very proud to the votes. Thank you.
I thank the Leader of the Opposition, and to conclude the case of side government and to conclude the grand finals, I call upon the Prime Minister, Shingo Fujita. Yes.
I'm going to ask three key questions in summary. Firstly, does retirement age make elderly people happy? Secondly, does our policy benefit young generation than that of the proposal from opposition? Last but not least, for your adjudication tips, why and which holistically which side had analyzed made the situation better for Japanese society as a whole? For that, two key points of clarification which does not directly fit in. So first, opposition reply speaker had talked about how, you know, corporations' right to cut individuals should be respected and sustained to this day. Just be clear, Retirement age policy is an institutional, systematic, governmental restriction against corporation to which corporation rights have no relevancy if they're concerned about relevancy in today's debate matters in today's debate. But second, they said at the last part of their reply, and the second opposition speaker talked about how the problem are minute, ages, and in what source, in what respect, their problem proposed by the government is minute and not necessarily important problem for Japanese society have to try to rectify that kind of things. Isolated, depressed old people with no purpose after retirement is going to be a serious problem according to us. What is the source as well as the criteria for those that side of the house to say that is not an important problem as a government to not take any consideration, which trivialize their problem? That's absurd. First question, elderly problem. So, first opposition speaker responded to our problem of elderly being under poverty and culturally discriminated against by saying the following. Firstly, cooperation is not mandatory, that's a lie. It is incentivized to hire people. Okay, that's difficult under a status quo because the perception for cooperation really matters associated with the culture as well as institutionalized policy or retirement age. People would see individual as non-comparative or non-competitive individual under a status quo. But furthermore, Alex add to that, no response, that kind of job they get is a seriously degraded kind of job which deprives individuals happiness as well as the self-pride under a status quo. But furthermore, they didn't and cannot have a radical policy. There's no alternative at all for that side of the house. But furthermore, increasing taxation system or corporate tax, then we would as well. What kind of exclusivity that you're talking about? But furthermore, on cultural degradation, there was no single response from that two speakers in their constructive material. Elderly people should be treated with respect. That was first principal argument to propose this policy. I'm quite critical against Japanese culture and current government as a liberal egalitarian, but I feel it is beautiful society to respect and cooperate with each other. This policy would contribute to that. But further, we have justified from the principle of autonomy, no response, because the value of autonomy do not decrease when people are old. Therefore, we could propose a policy with just concrete justification. Second, young generation. First opposition speaker had talked about, look, elderly is authoritative, that's damaging. Young generation is not progressive. Alex have told you, no response. On business, experience matters, but furthermore, you have 40 years or 40 men who have a fun with sexually harassing young female workers. The kind of structural like sexual harassment problem is not going to be solved under a policy. But furthermore, I feel immensely contradictory to first speaker and second opposition speaker. That is to say, when second speaker had talked about how individuals are able to become a consultant and corporation after retirement age, for example, that's very contradictory on their side of the house. Let's be clear. Side opposition do not show a clear-cut problem with regards to the power of influential old person. On contrast to that, we have substantiated the benefit associated with clarity, pension system, child care, invest to family, for example, working environment problem, which is more likely to foster political momentum to change the situation which makes younger generation happy. The third, most quite important criteria is holisticness. They only talk about cooperation, sexual harassment problems, etc. We have provided you in with specific analysis of the logic and contextualization of Japan. We have told you abolishing of retirement age will not magically solve the problem entirely, but we would have a concrete benefit and progress under our policy. With 12 grand finalists, I'm very proud to propose this policy.
That concludes the debate. Debaters across the floor shake hands, and we also have another big round of applause for the four grand finalists. Judges, please head back to the judge room and the very back there, and hand in your ballots in that room as well.